Be confident in your blackness. There's no one way to be black. There's no straitjacket. There's no constraints. There's no litmus test for authenticity.
President Obama delivering a pointed talk about, among other things, race at one of the nation's leading historically black colleges yesterday, Howard in Washington. Well, across the country, former Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice had a different message to graduates. She said, quote, "More people today enjoy lives of opportunity than in all of human history. This progress has been the concerted effort not of cynics, but of visionaries and optimists and idealists who deal with the world as it is, but who never stop working for the world as it should be."
We're here to break down the differences in those messages. Camille Foster, partner at freethinkmedia.com. Nice to see you this morning.
Good to see you. Thanks for having me.
So we were discussing earlier in the show this idea of blackness, and the president says that as if we all should know what that means. What does that mean?
It is actually incredibly difficult to define, and it's one of the reasons why I think the president said that there are about as many ways to be black as there are black people, which actually leaves you with something that seems pretty meaningless and empty. Which, quite frankly, is what I think when I think about race. I don't think it's the sort of thing that actually defines who we are. So when the president says to a classroom or a room full of graduating students, you should take pride in your blackness, take pride in this ephemeral thing that you happen to be, rather than in the things that you are actually able to accomplish, that strikes me as something that is very hollow and vapid and probably something that we should shy away from. I understand the instinct that in this country there has been sort of a history of discrimination, and that for some reason people may have felt shame associated with being black. But the appropriate response isn't for us to root our pride in our blackness. It's for us to regard race for what it is, this intangible thing that isn't of particular consequence that we ought to be always trying to move beyond, not embrace and hold close to us.
First of all, God bless you for saying that.
I got that from Zora Neale Hurston, who was also a Howard alum, who talked about race pride and how she didn't have time for race pride, that race pride works in two directions, that if you embrace race pride, you also have to embrace racial shame, that people who happen to look like you will do things that could be virtuous or not. And if they're doing things that aren't virtuous, then you own those things too. That seems ridiculous to me. Condoleezza Rice, when she spoke to mostly those same themes. And to be fair to the president, he also said that these students were inheriting a world that was better than the world that he grew up in, that we had overcome a great many challenges in this country. The trouble for the president, unfortunately, is when he gets things like that right, he also pairs it with just a little bit too much of the past, with a little too much of an emphasis on, well, there's still racial discrimination, there are still disparities. The disparities that exist, for example, in our criminal justice system, I am less concerned that we're locking up sort of less black people as a percentage of the population than that we're locking up less people overall. If you adjust those disparities so that we're locking up more white people, but it's still 50 million people that get locked up, that is a problem. That's not a solution. So I think he talks about these issues in the wrong way and oftentimes arrives at the wrong solution because of it.
It seems like this country is more divided than it's ever been, especially when it comes to blacks and whites. How do we move forward? How do we come together when we hear the president talk like this?
Interestingly, I don't think we are more divided than we've ever been. I do think we have a very poisonous and backwards conversation when it comes to race in this country, that we're overly sensitive about things. There was a moment in this speech where the president talked about black people, the bond between them is that they have a unique understanding of injustice. And if anything, unfortunately, that calibration, that thing that makes them understand injustice seems to be a little out of whack, because the Black Lives Matter movement has embraced any number of saints, like Mike Brown, for example, who by all accounts at this point, if we actually look at what happened there, by all accounts, he committed strong-arm robbery, potentially assaulted a police officer in the street, and there are still people who walk around as if he had his hands up, when there have been two independent investigations that have suggested that wasn't the case. Granted, there are problems with the criminal justice system. There are things that need to be reformed and accomplished in this country. We're not talking about those things if we're distracted by the fact that blacks happen to be overrepresented in certain criminal justice statistics.
So wouldn't you like to, I mean, everything you've said, I don't even know what your politics are, but I'm agreeing with you vehemently.
It's very moving.
Everything
that's
you've
good.
Said is so
It's
smart.
Always a good choice.
It is.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be nice to have a president, any president, Democrat or Republican, articulate the things that we have in common, the beliefs that we hold, regardless of what we look like? What does it mean to be American? I would like to hear that from somebody.
Yeah. What does it mean to be a good and virtuous human being? I mean, that is the standard, quite frankly. And to the extent that I had children and I don't have any, That is what I would ask them all the time. And when I encourage them to have pride, it would be, again, in the things that they had attained and they had accomplished. That's worthy of pride. My height, I didn't do anything to inherit
exactly.
those things.
Exactly.
The sun is out or it isn't. You deal with that.
Well, Camille Foster, I could listen to you all morning long.
Yeah.
Impressive.
We all just have our jaws dropped just listening to you.
Amen. Yeah.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Thanks
for being here.